What did I say to piss you off this time? Baby!
Who is the Negro in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood? In your neighborhood, I say. Who is the Negro in your neighborhood when you're running from his ass each day?
Black people don't hope, we wish.
Something that crazy could only come from you.
Right now you live in belief. You want to believe things. Belief is ignorance. Right knowledge is to know. Understand that? Belief is ignorance because belief is the acceptance of things that you do not know. And every one of your prayers end with Amen.
Let me hear you say amen. Oh, let me hear you say amen.
Amen, which is the ancient Egyptian god, Amun, and the Ra. The Ra was the sun in us as the original people of the sun. And we roamed the earth millions of years, 17,250,000 years exact, before Adam was created 49,000 years ago. Now, we don't know good people from bad. We don't know good food from bad. We don't know good music from bad. We don't know anything, and we were the ones who knew everything. And so they put us under a spell. What kind of spell? The spell of ghost worship. You understand? Ghost worship. And they said gospel. Ghost spell. All you know is what they told you, and you have belief in what they told you. When we were in our right state, state of Elohim, we didn't have beliefs. We knew, because we were the gods that everybody worshiped. They made us hate the rising of the sun by telling us, make sure you don't make fudge while the sun is rising. That's because we were sun people. People trying to get away from the sun made us start hating the sun. How'd they make you hate your hair? No, by telling you to pick cotton. The moment we stop conking our hair and cutting our hair and putting our feet on the grass again, things are going to start opening. We lost our eye and our light is dim.
Whoa. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Of course they flying over the top. They want to see what a motherfucker doing these days. That's right, from New York to Jamaica to Cali to Japan, Domo Domo live from Ground Zero. It's the fastest 30 minutes on air. Yo, radio show of shows, peoples. That's right. Bust that ass radio, 83.17 FMX. Any extras when you never saw me coming, when you never saw I was at, dumbass. Yo, Black Lenny Bruce on the loose, who's better than that balding mini-me, two-pump jump of a boyfriend. And yes, I'll run rings around that flat ass like Saturn, so test me, bitch. And if I say anything to offend you, then you know I'm doing my motherfucking job, because you have the option of turning me off when I keep turning you on again and again and again. Cash ass, let's ride, bitches. You know how we ride this shit. LA racist entitlement, so you know. The first question of the day is, if the contradiction of illegality is ever touted in difference to what's allowed under the pretense of what makes the future so bright by corporate and city corruption, then could it be that the motherfucker slipped on the money and it was way out here in Cali Whack-Ass, they slipped hard enough to challenge their authority on a subject they have no control over, especially if it's a natural choice? You be the judge. No, this is not Roe versus Wade. This is not the Violence Against Women's Act, nor is it for saving the parks. Those motherfuckers should have some of these elitist inner city golfing grounds turned into housing for the poor. Think not that I have to tell you again. God is perfect, man is not. Man made whiskey, but God made pot. Check it. Today, City Council has found itself within a Mexican standoff to repeal its ban on storefront medical marijuana dispensaries, or to have voters decide whether to squash the law or let it survive. We won't know anything till after the executive closed door voting session on Article 19 is over. Everybody that stood there in City Hall at the County City Council today were trying to question that shit, but they got beat down each and every fucking time. Like, we ain't discussing it, okay? There is held elation to this, okay? As you know, the city enforced a quote-unquote gentle ban on the dispensaries, which had the DEA bum-rushing the shit out of dispensaries out of Jose Wazar's district. He wanted to clean the shit up so he didn't look so fucking bad in front of Obama when he shows up. Oh, God, this shit goes even further. Basing a fear of drug-related corruption that the city itself can't tap into fully because nature's cure is illegal. has got to be the most asinine and arrogant calls of all time. Never mind the replacement refs, our replacement city council members are using replacement brains. It's a body snatcher thing, get it? Medical cannabis supporters bashed the law, saying high quality marijuana is difficult to grow and the gentle ban would deny cancer, AIDS, and other chronically ill patients one of the only medicines that provides relief from painful medical treatments. The Committee to Protect Patients and Neighborhoods, a coalition of medical marijuana advocacy groups, Americans for Safe Access, the Greater Los Angeles Collective Alliance, and the United Food and Commercial Workers Local 770 gathered 49,021 signatures to ask voters to overturn the law. Yet, Jose Huizar, the elitist sellout, is a weed racist. Okay, so now you know where I'm going with this, right? What the fuck? Okay, just last year he sided with the unpopular vote to keep his job and be one with the people, only to jump over the border that changes your cultural DNA and mindset the minute a motherfucker comes here illegally. But let's go further than that. All the chemical and prosthetic drugs that are made by Merrick somewhere in Sweden are deadly to the base of longevity with severe consequences. Keep watching the fucking commercials. Why is the possibility of death in everyone? Legally. GMOs, that chemically altered food, is highly profitable as it causes obesity rates and sickness at a higher rate per year, so that Merrick profits over the axiom of, quote unquote, you must remain sick in order for us to treat you, which is a cover for crime and punishment legally. Without chemical dependency, alcohol and its historic redneck prohibition would have died. But thanks to the fuckery of our government, it was one of the first means to generate a continuous genocide of the Native American Indian, especially the Apache, the continued incarceration and enslavement of black and brown men in a rife penal system that encourages cultural bias, killing legally. Better life through chemistry? More like supplication to a lesser god. Of course, there's no clear or perceptive ideal on how to regulate dispensaries unless you live in Colorado, where all of the major dispensaries allow Big Brother to monitor through mounted cameras within the facility. This gives the cops a good look at a daily activity and can spot out the posers all day, making them safely under a watchful honor system legally. Just watch for the Amendment 64 in Colorado. When the pebble hits the water, people, what then of its waves that spread out and becomes a boom in millions of dollars to both state and government legally? Think about it. I'll be black after this.
The pledge to resist. We believe living in the United States, it is our responsibility to resist the injustices done by our government in our names. Not in our name will you wage endless war. There can be no more deaths, no more transfusions of blood for oil. Not in our name will you invade countries, bomb civilians, kill more children, letting history take its course over the graves of the nameless. Not in our names will you erode the very freedoms you have claimed to fight for. Not by our hands will we supply weapons and funding for the annihilation of families on foreign soil. Not by our mouths will we let fear silence us. Not by our hearts will we allow whole peoples or countries to be deemed evil. Not by our will and not in our name. We pledge resistance. We pledge alliance with those who have undergone attack for voicing opposition to the war or for their religion or ethnicity. We pledge to make common cause with the people of the world to bring about justice, freedom, and peace. Another world is possible, and we pledge to make it real.
Yeah, I know. It's kind of funny, but hey, I haven't even gotten to that part yet. Moz, get those Facebook report.
Facebook, that bitch eat a dick.
Ah, the stuff I found on my Facebook. Crazy, shocking, but true. This sent in from Ass Buster, super producer and DJ Ravage, a pick post of a very popular game of Pac-Man. Only diff here is that it's titled Black Man, running after Kool-Aid, running away from the Klan, and getting extra points from fried chicken and Newport cigarettes. Funny how things stay the same, don't it? This in from Ass Buster Paradise Gray, a pick post of the revolutionary prophet Nat Turner, celebrating his birthday to declare it as Nat Turner Day every October 2nd. That's right, the toughest gong to swing a machete on his white oppressors. That's right, kill whitey. And finally, from Ass Busting Group, MoveOn.org, a pick post of a dystopian future for the nation's Supreme Court. And I mean, this should fucking let you know right off the bat. It says, three justices will turn 80 in 4 years. That's on the top of it. On the bottom, it says, don't let Romney win the election. What, do you need a slide rule to figure out where medicinal marijuana will go when he wins? Or do you need the NFL to let you know that Mittens has already been touted as the winner? No?
Naggers, Jews, homosexuals, Mexicans, Arabs, and all kinds of different chanks. Stay! Where would I start? Well, first of all, they're lazy, good-for-nothing tricksters, crack-smoking swindlers, big butt-having, wide-nose, breathing all the white man's air. They eat up all the chickens. They think they're the best dancers. And they stink. Did I mention that before?
Yes, I believe you did, sir.
Naggers, Jews, homosexuals, Mexicans, Arabs, and all kinds of different chanks stink.
He was the only Negro we'd ever had around here. He was the only Negro we'd ever had around here. So we figured we'd make it easier on Clayton by just telling him and all the other blind kids that he was white.
Oh, the horror! The horror! The fucking horror! Blacka Barka! For most of the non-ciphers of religious rebuke, the naysayers of diabetes and the disgust, after disgust, of fishbowl consumption. Yes, all right, I've been saying this shit all my fucking life. Pork kills. Check it. You need fucking verification. Here it is. Oregon authorities are investigating why Terry Vance Garner, age 69, never returned after he set out to feed his animals last Wednesday on his farm near the Oregon coast. Now, his animals happen to be hogs, pigs. All right. A family member found Garner's dentures and pieces of his body in a hog enclosure several hours later, but most of his remains had been consumed on Pork Chop Hill by some of his hogs, some weighing in as much as 700 pounds. Okay, how the fuck are you gonna get a 700-pound fat bitch off you? I don't know. With pork being the 90% entree in many poor homes, the pig has gone through some biological changes to feed a greedy nation. Now that some got tired of the exploits, we can safely call this movie the reincarnation of Fat Turner. When a pig killed Whitey. Just shameful. God rotting off of it. What? There was, you know, where's the cornbread? Mac and cheese or green beans of male sterility on the plate? I mean, come on. The fucking pig ate his ass up, literally. Damn. I mean, shit, talk about motherfucking, you know, fucking crumbled pork cookies. Ha! Shit.
This is called racial profile. It was the color of his skin that scared them. It wasn't that he was 5'6" tall. It was the color of his skin that scared them. It wasn't that he weighed 150 pounds. It was the color of his skin that scared them. It wasn't the wallet. It was the color of his skin that scared them. The wallet was never a gun. It was the color of his skin that scared them. He looked like somebody capitalism taught them to kill. somebody oppressed, somebody exploited, somebody from Africa, an immigrant, somebody whose ancestors were slaves, like 3/5 of a person, like somebody it would take 41 bullets to kill. He looked suspicious, like something inhuman, something it would take 41 bullets to kill. He looked like somebody capitalism taught them to kill. It wasn't Ugali. It was the color of his skin that determined his worth. 4 racist cowards killed 1 Amadou Diallo 19 times. They should be in jail serving 41 plus 19 life sentences in consecutive order. I got it right, now tell me I got it. I got it right, now tell me I got it right. I got it right, now tell me I got it right. I got it right, now tell me I got it right.
Oh yeah, they're running hot today. Dirty condoms. Now ain't this some shit? I went to the 99 cent store. Yes, I know, one penny short of a dollar, but then again, there are people who fit the demographic. The motherfuckers got a city notice for suspected gouging of their prices. That's a Korean thing, since they own the liquor stores and everything else. That takes four interpreters to spend a buck. And they have security, I fuck you through the entire store. Serving news. We got new neighbors in the building. Nice couple. Unlike the drama that manifested with a bunch of slack ass kids trying to be grown, only to be booted for squatting. Now that the boss lady who owns the building is mad, bam, they raised the rent. So while everyone that works foots the bill for this asshole who still lives in the building for free, let this be a reminder that he's about to have his ass handed to him. I don't give a fuck if it's my goddaughter's boyfriend or not. Joel's got no intention of getting his shit together, hanging out at the fucking library even as we speak. I ain't working to take care of nobody's fucking kids when the bitch ain't even trying to look my fucking way. Man, please. All right. You know, y'all can fucking hang that shit up. Real for real. Y'all can hang that shit up. Because I will definitely make sure that this will be the easiest fucking ass kicking of all time. Okay, it's that bell time for cultural nepotism. Oh yes. Hey Mittens, have you figured out what numbers to pull out of your pasty white ass or what? If you need help, I have a list of conservative liberal niggas lined up for your support. The only thing is that they're in Skittle pieces in front of your San Diego home. Yes, he does have one, and as soon as I have the address, I'm going down there to shit on his front door. But then again, when niggas is nonpartisan, the field is open and retort videos are commonplace. The latest flaming butt plug is from AFSCME. What a long ass acronym. Fuck it. This is where we see Richard Hayes picking up Mitten's trash at his La Hala estate, you know? The one that needs elevators for all his cars. Ballin' rich crackers still need 47% slaves to avoid health issues if the trash is not picked up regularly. It could be a very bad scene if no one picked up the man's shit, now would it? But let's stick a much hotter knife in the gash. As we all know, Bain Capital was Mitten's bastard mistake. It had a few businesses under its financial chicken wing. One of them, Guitar Center, which is now on the verge of bankruptcy because of them. I know James Brown is probably laughing his ass off right now, and Sam Ash across the street is waiting for the spillover. My question in this niggatopia, if Lauren Obama has to clean up the political mess left over by a messy white motherfucker like that, what level of stupidity, and I mean that is spelled with two O's, are you really in favor for when that messy motherfucker is blatantly looking to do the same goddamn thing? Okay? After the debates, vote for the clarity, not for the masturbator.
Today's more Republicans are running from Romney. The Romney campaign is in full panic mode, trying to save the sinking ship. But he has a new strategy. For 3 days since the secret tape was revealed, Mr. Romney's been on damage control. He's trying to put his spin on the secret tape. He's trying to see what he can say after getting caught saying 47% of Americans are freeloading off the government. He could have responded in any number of ways to the tape. What did he do? He did this.
First of all, this is a campaign about the 100%. So my campaign is about the 100% of America, and I'm concerned about them. I'm concerned about the fact that over the past 4 years, life has become harder for Americans. More people have fallen into poverty. This is a campaign about helping people who need help, and right now, the people who are poor in this country need help getting out of poverty. The people in the middle class need help. I care about the 100%. People in America are going to have a better future if they elect me the next president.
Does he think we're stupid? I mean, honestly, does he think the American people are stupid? Mr. 1% and now Mr. 47% now wants us to believe he's Mr. 100%? 3 days ago, we heard him call 47% of the country victims who mooch off the government. This is what he said about them. My job is not to worry about those people. Yet, magically, all of a sudden, he's concerned about all Americans. Give me a break. Governor Romney's new strategy, his play for the middle class, his play for all Americans, just gave President Obama the political equivalent of a sledgehammer to go on the attack today.
People want a hand up, not a handout. The people who are not paying income taxes are either paying a lot of taxes because they're working every day, but they just don't make enough money overall to pay income tax. Or alternatively, they're senior citizens, or they're students who I know these guys aren't making a lot of money, even with some work study programs, or they're disabled, or in some cases they're veterans or soldiers who are fighting for us right now overseas. They don't pay an income tax. And so I just think it's very important for us to understand Americans work hard, and if they're not working right now, I promise you they want to get to work, and that's what my economic plan is designed to do, to get more people back to work and to lift up the middle class and people who want to work to get into the middle class.
I mean, you expect that kind of a scream off a fucking scary ass movie, but this is kind of scary. I mean, just think of it. There are people around you right now who've done some foul shit and will continue to do foul shit because, let's do this on three so y'all can get the hint of it, all right? On one, on two, and that means take two hands and pull that shit apart and look at it for what it is. And on three, with a mighty woo-sah, asshole of the day. As the heat continues through the fall of Babylon, one motherfucker's on the hot seat, but what strikes me is cold and divisive to humane situations and solutions to treatment of the greatest minority in LA, the prison population, 80% in Midland Central is black and brown. Niggas and spick is what it is, ain't it? Or is it the prize for living the life? Now, let's dig in that ass and get up in there. I mean, way in there. Lee Baca, sheriff and lead fuckface of the penal state scandal of crimes against prisoners, has a lot going on behind prison bars now, doesn't he? Murders, death fights, contract and bounties on or against prisoners by his own appointed deputies. the rows of people that have spoken before the Los Angeles County Board of Supervisors by way of nonprofit organizations have all said the same thing. The communities of color live in fear of the penal state systems. And the lack of humane leadership and human oversight is enough to call for the bastard's balls on a punji stick. Alright? What the fuck? Alright? A commission appointed to investigate Los Angeles County's jail said Friday the system has shown a quote-unquote persistent pattern of unnecessary and excessive force, unquote, and blamed Sheriff Lee Baca for the failure of leadership. The Citizens Commission on Jail Violence, a seven-member panel made up of several former judges and a police chief, released its final report Friday after a lengthy investigation of the nation's largest county jail system and the treatment of some 15,000 inmates by the sheriff's department, who runs it, and they're running for Mr. Block. But the commission said, quote-unquote, force-first attitude has reigned in the jail system and relied too much on intimidation and humiliation to establish control of inmates. Quote, LASD personnel have used force against inmates when the force was disproportionate to the threat posed, or there was no threat at all, when disciplined and discouraged against deputies, and there was little training or guidance in the instances when force should be used, unquote. Boo fucking who? To wait for this motherfucker to just ease his way out of office is with his tail between his legs, like, you know, it only makes his ass beating that much longer to effect. Both the Police Oversight Commission and the LA County Board of Supervisors have the power to call for a resignation. But think about it, peeps. The only way that's going to happen is that we riot in the fucking streets to the injustice. I mean, come on, Daryl Gates went fast, didn't he? Hint, hint, hint. Okay. So what if we vote off the death penalty? Big fucking deal. It's just a means more overcrowding for bullshit, okay? For bullshit trumps by law enforcement. The quicker we kill that bastard Baca, the better. But then again, you know, he has the backing of a Teflon Don with a lot of racist police leagues that support him. Like Ronald Reagan did during the Iran-Contra affair, he won't recall. But he'll patsy your ass if you're that close to him. Notice to self, the pigs don't live in the hood, niggas. Okay, therefore, for the third time running like Cool C Diddy, the Baca, you are the asshole of the day.
That's the sound of the police. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the beast. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the police. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the beast.
There is no justification. None at all. For responding with violence.
I have three kids. My three kids in the car by themselves. I took my mom a ride on the scene. They didn't give me my Miranda rights. 11 o'clock payment, 11 o'clock on my phone the next day. Then some man coming in with a piece of paper talking about I'm under arrest. But I've been here since 4 o'clock p.m. You just now arrested me. It's 11, 12 o'clock the next morning. So why am I in here if I wasn't arrested? My brother got shot, like they said, in the back of the head, came through out his temple, in the back of the leg, in the back. Why did you do that? He said you had a gun. And I've been out there for 10 hours, and nobody find no gun, and nobody find the item that they say in the news that he was trying to take. Where the victim at? You just seen, it wasn't even a phone call, said he robbed somebody. You just happened to be going that way and seen an African-American running and start to take the suit. You didn't know what was going on until after he was already dead. So why did you kill him? That's what I want to know.
Watch out! We run through y'all!
There is no justification, none at all, for responding with violence.
If I was here just now and said, oh, I feel threatened, I'm licensed to carry a gun, I murdered someone here because I felt threatened, there was no gun found with neither one of them, and the only thing that this family has gotten back was because they're the police department and they felt threatened for their lives, and they were licensed to carry a gun. That's injustice. I feel like there needs to be a thorough investigation. The police, whoever's involved.
Okay, and if you missed it, then play it again till you get it. You can say moving forward like a bitch, but you know I'm ahead of your bullshit. This has been your radio station, 83.17 FM X. Then the X stands for, you didn't see me coming when you never saw where I've been, all up in your ass. Steady shellac in the room, pump harder than ever. Booty bubbles, dirty condoms. Music provided by Omega 7 Records, the Mothership Connection, aka Destruct, and the underground music scene. Cash your ass. See you in the street, bitches.
Why? There is no justification. None at all.